Now, let's talk about another subject, which is called the mobile generation. And mobile generation, briefly, is the evolution of the mobile and the story of 2G, 3G, 4G, and 5G right now is the generation. So G here is short for generation. So now, what is the story of 2G, 3G, and 4G? And why did this evolution happen? For starters, in the past, there was something called 1G, but it vanished. And I didn't even write it on the table, as it is not even available worldwide anymore. 1G was the biggest evolution that landed in the past and was used for calls or voice calls. But if you remember in the past, cell phones were very expensive back then. The SIM card of the mobiles were also expensive. The cost of a call per minute was very expensive. There weren't even any messages. The coverage wasn't effective. You could barely find places of coverage. No one was holding mobiles that much, except only for the businessmen. So 1G was an evolution back at that time. But right now, it's of no use to us. Now, the beginning of evolution, the actual evolution happened with the start of 2G. And this 2G allowed us all to carry mobiles. The cost of a call per minute decreased. The websites started to increase. The mobiles started to become cheaper. The types of mobiles even increased, like Nokia, Samsung, all these types and kinds of mobile providers appeared. And there was a dramatic change in evolution that happened in the mobile industry. And we started to actually hold phones when the 2G appeared. So you can understand the communication field. This field is based upon what is called the frequency. So briefly, your calls are paired on frequency. All right. So let's make a small drawing here. A small example. Imagine this is a cell tower. All right. And let's say that this is the antenna. Let's not worry about the antenna right now. And this is the frequency waves coming out of it. And this is yourself. Sorry for the drawing. Right. So again, let's say that this is the tower, and let's not worry about the antenna anymore. And I just want to give you guys an idea about the call itself. So you stand here, sending and receiving calls, and this sending and receiving is done by frequencies. All right. So now we agree that a frequency is what this field overall is based on. And this topic is what will be occupying the rest of the course, as we will be talking about these frequencies and how they're used. Now, this 2G came down with two things, something called GSM, another thing called DCS. Now, GSM is short for Global System for Mobile Communication, and DCS is short for Digital Cellular System. So GSM came with a frequency of 900 megahertz. So you can actually send and receive your calls in case of GSM or 2G GSM. This frequency gave me the services of voice and SMS, and also gave me a large coverage, but with a small capacity. And what does this mean? So 900 megahertz is very small. So it's a small frequency. And there was an evolution we all passed by. Sorry, there was an equation that we all passed by in our studies, which states that the length of the wave is inversely proportional to the frequency. Just a small reminder so you guys can remember that part. All right. length of the wave is inversely proportional to the frequency, all right? So if the wavelength increases, the frequency decreases. And if the frequency increases, the wavelength decreases. So why here is there a large coverage? Because it's a small frequency, all right? All right, now, but let me ask you, let's say another small drawing so we can make things a bit clear. All right. So this is a small frequency, but it gave me a large coverage. So again, this is a small frequency that could give me a large coverage. But why small capacity? It is normal because this small frequency could be divided, except to a fewer small channels, because it's like I'm dividing something with a length of 1 meter, for example. I will divide it to 10 pieces because it's small. But here I'm dividing something like 10 centimeters, so I can divide it. That's the idea of large coverage and small capacity, all right? So large coverage gave me a big coverage area because the frequency is inversely proportional with the wavelength, but a small capacity or fewer users. And why fewer users? Because it is a small frequency. And this is the GSM, all right? Okay. Now, the 2G DCS, which is the abbreviation for digital cellular system, this came down with a frequency of 1,800 megahertz, which is a high frequency, and gave me the same services of voice and SMS, but small coverage with large capacity. Why? Because it has a high frequency. Okay, so again, let's draw the tower and the frequency waves that come out of it. So this is high frequency, which is inversely proportional to the wavelength. So increased frequency means small wavelength. So here, I can't serve except something close to the network. But here it gave me an advantage of large capacity. Why? Because it is a high frequency, so I could cover more users. So 2G, when it came down with these two bands, it actually did a very good move. Let's draw another drawing here. So again, let's say that this is the cell tower, all right? And this is the GSM for faraway people, all right? And this is the DCS for close people, all right? So this is the GSM for faraway people, and the DCS covered the close people. So it covered all this area, all right, by 2G. All right, I hope you guys got the point. Now, again, because of this 2G, we could all actually use mobiles. Now, the evolution started again, and we came down with 3G. And 3G first came with a band of 2,100 megahertz. And 3G gave me the services of voice, video calls, SMS, and data, or internet. And yes, it's weak, but would any of us imagine that your phone has even internet? And yes, in our times, there wasn't like Facebook or YouTube, but it was a dream for us to actually have a mobile with internet. And by this 2100 megahertz, or the 2100 band, the wavelength is less and has small coverage, but provides me more capacity. All right. Okay. And so we can cover far and near. They came down with a band of U900 that has 900 megahertz, which also gave me the voice, the video calls, SMS data, which is internet, all right, but with a large coverage. Now, when 3G appeared, it was a major evolution. But take care, I'll tell you a few things about 3G, 2G, and 4G at the end. Now, after 4G came down, and it is called in this field the LTE, which is long-term evolution. It came down with many bands, like the 700, 800, 1800, 2100, 2300, 2600 megahertz. As all of these are bands that are used in the 4G, you can find the site having two bands as well. And we will understand the bands and its functions later on. Now, the 4G gave me the services of voice over LTE, all right, and video calls, data or internet with high, data or internet with high speed. As when I open YouTube with 4G, I don't even wait for the video to buffer. If the network is good, its speed is very fast, YouTube will open automatically in a sec, in just a second. Now, there is 5G. We've heard about 5G a lot, but we haven't seen a plan for 5G yet. Now, 5G is known for 5G NR, which is short for new radio, which came down with bands of 2100, all right, 3300, 3500, 4200 megahertz. Now, let's imagine it. It says that 5G is faster than 4G 100 by 100 times. When you download, it's actually the link rate or the download rate, it's 10 to 20 gigabits per second, which is actually unimaginable. You can also download 2 to 3 movies, which are HD per 1 second. Now, the movie actually, like, if I'm downloading a movie and I'm on 4G, it can take like 15 minutes if it's like 1 gigabyte, all right? That's if it's, let's say it's a movie. Let me give you some fruitful information about 2G, 3G, and 4G and its bands. First thing, let's imagine that you guys are on a desert road. Let me just put that down just a second. Okay. So let's imagine that you guys are on a desert road, all right? Here's the road, all right? Sorry about that. All right, so just let's imagine that this is the road and this is the tower, all right? And here are antennas, all right? And okay, so I want the tower that I make here to have the highest coverage in all directions. As you drive a distance till the network cuts off, till the other site or tower picks up. But let me ask you, should I use on the desert roads high frequencies like the 1800 megahertz and the 2100 megahertz? Actually, no, it's of no use. But on desert roads, And by roads, or these roads, I mean the traveling desert roads, not the desert itself. You will find that this road, this band, you'll find that this road has the band of 900 megahertz, all right? And now the U900 of 900 megahertz, actually it's in the past. There was only, in the past, there was only GSM, all right? And it was stated that the, or let's say that you are driving and you want to make a call, why wouldn't I give you internet? But with the advanced technology, they are giving you the U900. And by the way, there are some desert roads that now have actually 4G. I just want you to understand that 2G, 3G, or 4G on desert roads are with small frequencies. So they can have a large coverage. Now, let me answer your question as to of why we don't have 5G in some countries. It is not as easy as you think, all right? So again, having 5G is not easy, but why? This actually needs international permits. So a network can convert from 2G to 3G, it won't convert by itself. You have to put it on the network, or you have to put in the network the equipment that could get you 3G. So this is all not easy. It needs a lot of permits for you to convert or to add to the network 3G. Not this only, but your phone itself, if it's 2G and won't read 3G, so if you get this phone, a SIM card of 3G, it won't actually read it. So you will have to get another phone that supports 3G. Our mobiles a while ago could only serve till 4G. As from the factors that make a mobile price go down, rather just than its camera or processor or battery, is the 5G itself, all right? So, the 5G, if a mobile does not have 5G, its price will go down. Now, let's say that my phone's maximum capacity or the maximum for it is 4G. When I sell it, I'll get another phone that supports 5G. As when 5G fully launches, I'll be prepared to use all its services. For example, Huawei made a million mobiles, or let's say Samsung made a million mobiles that can only support 4G. And you sold them to a country that will have 5G. I will lose in this case. And this is not done easily, as this is an economical situation. So like if you have a phone that only supports 4G and costs, for example, like 5,000, when 5G arrives, it will drop to 3,000 and no one will actually buy it. So why would I buy a phone who only serves 4G? I will buy something that serves 5G. So if someone asks you why in some countries they don't have 4G or 5G, you need to understand that this doesn't happen easily. It needs governmental and international permits, and devices need to be changed in the networks or added on the network. And mobiles also need to change as well. So this is a huge thing that needs a lot of work. This is the story of the generation.